Hello, this is Bern, and on today's episode, I'm going to be sharing with you how to choose your ideal guy, so stick with me. Hello, this is Bern. Welcome to your greatlifetoby.com, a space where I share with ambitious, conscious, heart-centered, and successful women how you can create the relationship you want and attract the kind of quality man that you want into your life as a result of stepping into the most alive and most feminine version of you without playing games, manipulation, techniques, or gimmicks. Now, on this part three of this five-part series, I'm going to go deeper into how to choose your ideal guy. I'm not going to go into the qualities I suggest necessarily finding in a man. I may be not sure one, but the majority, because I've addressed that in previous videos, and I'll link one up here, but I'm going to talk about the principles that you need to step into if you want to stop wasting time with men who are not the right fit for you. If you want to stop feeling anxious unnecessarily through the process of dating. If you want to make sure that your worth and your confidence shines as a result of the relationship instead of feeling doubtful and unworthy. Step number one is you need to know your non-negotiables before you put yourself out there and start dating. Why is this important? Because this is going to ensure that you don't waste time with someone who's a clear hell no for you before you start. So, for example, if smoking is something that's a non-negotiable for you, meaning if somebody smokes, that's you can't go forward, then you need to know that in advance. If you need to make sure that someone is highly religious of your specific religion or spiritual without religion or not religious at all, you need to know that before you start dating. Do you want to get married, yes or no? Or are you open to exploring but not really set on that idea? Do you want children? Do you want a family? Would you take a guy who has previous children even though they're not your own? All those things are important questions that you need to do your own homework and step into it knowing what it is that you want. I suggest not to have tons of non-negotiables, but you need to have a few, a handful of non-negotiables, maybe three, four, that are really important to you so that you can ensure a better fit when you start connecting with guys. Step number two that you need to do if you want to choose your ideal guy is you need to get to know him, and to get to know him, part of the process is spending time, part of the process is asking good questions early and often. Why? Because if you don't ask questions early, then you run the risk of investing a lot of time getting emotionally attached to someone and then getting your heart broken unnecessarily. So if you ask early and often, that means that you're willing to check in midway through getting to know him. If the guy still feels the same way about the way he used to feel before about a specific subject, especially the important ones. If you ask early enough what the guy is interested in and the guy says, I'm not sure what I'm looking for right now, well, if you do, that would be a showstopper for me. If a guy is just like going through life, he's 40, 50 years of age, he doesn't know what he wants, that would be a let me run the hell away from you right now. And if you ever get clear, maybe you can reach back and connect with me. But until then, don't waste my freaking time. Number three, don't buy into the projection. Don't buy into the projection means that you're going to connect with a guy, and if the chemistry is strong, the tendency will be that you will fill in the gaps with your imagination and ideas of the future that may have zero basis in reality. You want it to be that way, but it's not that way. So I'll give you an example. If you've ever done one of those crossword puzzle type things where there's a word and there's maybe two letters on that long sentence and you have to figure out what other letters fill in, the fewer letters on that sentence, the higher likelihood that what you're thinking that word phrase is incorrect. Same thing with a guy. The less time you've spent with him, the more your projection is running the show. The more time you've spent with them, the more you've had time to adjust projections versus reality and gauge if what your hypothesis was about the guy is true, or if you need to have a reality check and ask more questions or even step back and stop dating him altogether. Number four. Wait for intimacy, okay? Wait for that level of connection with them. Why? Because my guess is if you want a lifelong relationship with someone, you're going for depth versus excitement. And it doesn't mean that you can't have an exciting experience with them. It just means that you're gonna have to sacrifice the 0 to 60 miles an hour from a Ferrari in 2.9 for longer so that it's not empty intensity. there's a lot of excitement in empty intensity, but by definition, if it's empty or empty-ish, it's going to leave you hungry. It's like having a bag of potato chips when you're really hungry. It's nutritionally void. Might do the trick for a few minutes, but you're going to be hungry 30 minutes later. So don't do that. So as I said, wait for intimacy. Second to that would be step number 5, is wait for exclusivity. Why? Because if you wait for exclusivity, you are going to make far better decisions than if you say, well, if what I need to do to be with a guy, intimately have sex with him is be exclusive. Let's solve that one right now. Let's be exclusive from day number 1. Well, it doesn't work quite that way, sweetheart. And here's why. Because unless you get a chance to go the distance with him, see how he interacts in good times, in bad times, when there's an argument, how does he react towards you? When there's a challenge in his life, does he run away? Does he hide under a cave or under a bush? Does he face problems head on with a courage that makes you appreciate him even more? The longer you are in this type of exploration with him, unexclusively, the better off you'll be in terms of making the right choice from a more objective and detached perspective versus completely submerged into an illusion. Number 6, friendship is the foundation of any long-lasting intimacy. So as you get to know the guy better, as you date him for some time, as you create meaningful experiences, as you have deep conversations, as he gets a chance to step up and help you through your challenges that come up with life, and you do the same with him, you will develop a friendship. And the friendship will dictate the depth and also the longevity of this relationship. You need to be able to have the confidence and the capacity to discuss important information, important topics, and to really understand and see each other. And again, if you're sensing a theme around all of these points, is time. There is zero substitute for time to account for the clarity of getting to know someone well and to go for depth versus that immediate feeling of how it can work. Number 7, and this is the one point I'll share about his personal characteristics. Watch and observe his relationship to responsibility. What do I mean by that? I have a video, complete video on this topic, but I'll give you the short Cliff Notes version. You need to connect with a guy who has a strong sense of ownership of responsibility in his life. Why? The more he is of the idea that responsibility is a burdensome thing that he should move away from, the less likelihood he'll be a great dad, less likelihood he'll be a great partner, the less likelihood he's going to stick around in times of trouble. And trust me, there'll be plenty of fucking times of trouble in any relationship. So unless he's willing to have a deep relationship to responsibility where he thrives on taking on some of the weight of the world to transform and make it better, then you're probably looking more at a child or a teenage adolescent, mind-wise, even if he's not biologically there, that you have to mother through life, and that's not something you want. So hope these are helpful principles for you to understand how to step into the relationship the right way and have to have the mindset of an ultra marathon versus a sprint that allows you to get what you want. If you find this is helpful, I'm going to ask you to do 3 things. Number 1, click like or thumbs up on this video. Number 2, subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already, and click the little bell to be notified of new episodes, including the last two of this series. And if you want to go deeper, I've created a masterclass that allows you to learn what it really takes to step into the best relationship of your life. And if you want to do that, click on the first link on the description of this video. When prompted, enter your name and email, and then you'll be immediately redirected to that masterclass. If you want my help, hand-holding, accountability, instead of trying it on your own, trial and error on your own, which sometimes is painful, and you want to shorten that time span to get what you want, the second link under the description of this video will allow you to apply to work with me. Thank you so much for connecting. And as always, I challenge you to live a full and a conscious life.